Huh?
What are you gonna say? Can you bring me to the junkyard?
Yeah, I'm bringing this geek to the junkyard. He never junkyards. Hey, I found some sockets too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
My ass is crazy, dude.
We only came for this. Ricardo needs these four bolts for a project dream truck he's working on. No, it's a customer's truck, but he showed up without the driveline bolts. We're trying to get it finished, and we got lucky because we found this tail light too. This one is broken, and turns out the one we need is on this side, so perfect. Yeah, that one got mangled too. That RAV4. Square bodies. Got it? Huh?
I can't get it out. Es que se atora con la llave in the driveway.
You can't get what out? The
bolt.
Why? Because you need to turn the dry line or what?
No, because I got to turn on. So when I'm backing it out, this hits the drive line.
Oh.
Almost como que like I needed like a wobble socket and an impact.
Well, how did you get the other one out? How'd you get that one out?
Because on the angle.
No, I know, that's what I'm saying. So you think if we turn it or what?
Maybe, yeah.
Will it turn or no? All of them are in the air?
Yeah, but the thing is, I don't know if the transmission.
It's probably in four-wheel drive.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have anything in the front. Have you tried to spin it or no? Huh? Yeah, pero digo, none of the tire, nothing's hitting on the floor. Even if it's on the transmission, it should still turn. Unless it has an e-brake. You think they wrecked and they put the e-brake?
Nah, it's in gear.
It's in gear?
Yeah.
Oh. What? What surprises you? Because he works outside?
Yeah.
He works. Dude, it was 3 feet of snow last time. Nah, like a foot of snow. He was working outside.
That's nuts.
Yeah. That's his shop. That's his shop right there. That shed? That's his shop.
You can handle me.
Eh?
You can handle me where I'm working.
Because you're running out of propane, okay? You don't want to work. You know that. You know that one of the things that makes him strong is that, you know those big new trucks that they test over there, uh-huh, where you said that facility?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they bring them here. Oh, and he has to crush them.
That's crazy.
He has to crush them. The only thing they let him keep is like some of the parts, like the wheels, differentials, and stuff like that. Yeah, see, these are brand new. Look.
Oh, shit.
And he says, dude, it sucks because they come over and they pour something into the engine.
Yeah,
because they don't have any VIN numbers or anything.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, but a lot of stuff they get to keep.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. You see, that's one of them. That big semi.
Oh yeah.
And he says that there's times where they don't. They come over and they don't tell them that,
uh-huh,
and they take the engine quick, and then they just tell the company, "Oh, we already crushed it." But he says it's illegal to sell them because they don't have VIN numbers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. One Subaru, two Subarus, three Subaru, four, five, six. And a lot of them over there. Well, we are in the heart of the Subarus. Towns, or town. Yeah, this is because of the snow. Any model, any color. You know what I need for those kids? But I didn't bring all the tools. That Mini Cooper, the injectors.
Oh, yeah. You should just automatically just grab them every time you do it.
Yeah.
Let's dance in style, let's dance for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies. Hoping for the best but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sad pit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever and ever.
The radiator's still there, huh?
But it looks like it's been smashed.
Oh, yeah, yes. The light is right there.
Yeah, the light's here.
No, this one too, look, it's on top. Yeah. Or is it not for this one? Yeah, it's for this one.
Yeah.
But he wants 75 bucks, so. At 75 bucks, I think I'd rather buy him new. I'm gonna check them out right now and see how much they're new. It was manual. It still has the engine and transmission. Remember what we were talking about? The D-series transmission? This is it.
This is it?
Yeah. Get that transmission and that half shaft. And this is the one that you just switch all the internals into a regular D-series transmission. And it's pretty much like you have a B-series transmission. The axles are bigger, the splines are bigger. Yeah. And it has a half shaft too.
So has it tiny in there?
Yeah, it still has it in there. So, if somebody wants to build a good, fast D-series, that would be the way to go. Okay, we found some stuff that we needed. We are still looking for an element. We just need the radiator and the headlights and the fans. But, no luck. Also, the headlights, I might end up just buying them new. Drove all the way over here on the phone online. It says that they had only one. Turns out they have three, but the prices went up while we were here. Now they want $75 each. On the phone, they told me they wanted like $30-$35 or so, and they doubled the price while here. So at that price, I might as well just buy them new. But I don't know, I might just buy the radiator just so we can drive it around and we're not pushing it. But we'll see. We still got Jose went to go find out. He went to go find out if where they're at. He also went to go ask how much the radiator is and how much a battery, because he found a battery for his MR2. But all in all, it's looking like a bust. So I'm gonna start walking back and meet Joseph. I was walking the yard and I came across this, and I know Mikey needs his door, same color too. So there you go, Mike. He has a mirror, he has everything. He just needs the door itself. It's already bare, so it'll be perfect for him to just come and grab it, throw it on his Subaru, and post it up for sale. Same color. And that's what we need, right?
And they asked to capture the fluid. Or let them know, because they don't want to spill the fluid. So now we have to go over there and let them know that we want to take it.
Are you
I'm serious.
I'm not gonna go. I'm just gonna tell them it was already missing a bunch of radiator hoses. There's no fluid.
Already disconnected.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna tell them. So my thing is, I should might as well take this, no?
That looks new. Well, I mean, there's some damage done here.
Yeah.
But it doesn't look like
But I need those. The headlights, maybe they're off, no? The hood is here. Yeah, the headlights are in here. I'm gonna see if I can get a
knock down the
prize. I'm telling them that they've been in here and they're scratched and whatnot. Okay. Is the other one over there or no?
I don't see it.
Oh, great. So we only have one. Okay. Well, let's get those off. On today's episode, I'm going to do a front main seal on this one. I just spray some acid. We're going to wash the engine.
It's leaking oil really bad. So, zoom in. So yeah, I'm going to be doing that. Leaks oil really bad. So,
yeah, I'm going to be doing that. We just got back from the junkyard. These Negroes working on this. Well, turns out I paid $140 for that radiator. This, the reservoir, or overfill, whatever, overflow, the fans. I thought I was getting a good deal. But it was $55 just for the radiator. It was $50 each fan and $40 for this right here, the overflow. And he's like, you know what? I'm gonna give you a deal, $140, take it all. And I'm gonna cut you a deal on it, that way you don't have to come back because you need this and that. And he pretty much sweet talked me into it. And I took the hook. And then when we got here, we just needed the radiator. Those parts are in the back of that other element that they gave me. So bummer. And when we are selling them, nobody wants to pay us $10, $20 for those fans. But then again, we don't need them, then we end up throwing them away. So, yeah. But I thought it was a good deal because, hey, each hose, I don't want to buy a hose. I got to buy the hose. Then I had to buy this. You guys remember these necks, these water necks on the K-Series? They're plastic, so it's broken. Another thing I found out is we have an AC compressor on that element. It's just hanging there. So it has the AC compressor and some hoses. So the only thing we're probably gonna need is an AC condenser, which I left on that other one. And I'm gonna see if we can do some trading, I'll probably return those fans in that. Cause this was more expensive. He gave me these $40 each, so it's 80. This one was 40, and he supposedly gave it to me for $20. So just there is 40, 40, 80, and 20. That's $100. I paid 145. So I don't know, I needed it, so I brought it. And Joseph has it all ready to tack it, right?
Mocked up, ready to...
It's all mocked up, and you're gonna tack it?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what he's gonna do. And then the AC compressor busted. So like I said, I was gonna buy it too, but I was like, man, I'm gonna wait. Good thing I did. Because that one has it, it's just there. And it has hoses too, so we only need a few hoses. Don't need them all. And yeah, anyways, the story on this is, you guys remember where he was sitting there in the front? One of my relatives drove by and he said he was looking for a car, and he came over and he saw it. And he says, hey man, how much do you want for it if you fix it? I told him I had all the parts, I just needed to put some time and effort to it. And I told him, give me about a week and I'll be ready. And he offered me some money and I took it. And well, I didn't take it. I told him yes. And he says, okay, get it done and then I'll buy it off of you. So I probably could have made the same amount of money if I parted out. But I don't want to have more cars here in my yard. I'm trying to clean the yard. And then another thing is, once this one leaves, I'm going to post that other one. For a party now, whatever it lasts is. If it lasts a week or two, and then just junk it. We're going to start filling it up with junk metal. And the Minions. Joseph named these kids the Minions because they're always laughing. So yeah, the students, this is how far they've gone into it. We did the axles. That's what they did. Yeah, yesterday they did the axles and the motor mounts and the alternator. We needed to do the starter. Well, they needed to do the starter, and then we also removed the oil pan. They removed the oil pan for the we're gonna do the bung on it for the return line, that turbo. Yeah, and yeah, they're probably gonna throw those seats back in the car, so that way they're not there. I forgot, I should have told them to do that. So that's that. I'm gonna get to that van, get it out of here, and that's what we're gonna do today. I was supposed to go to work today, but I didn't because I needed to get this one done. Okay, so the owner told me to replace the front main seal. They had diagnostic, he went to a Jiffy Lube or whatever, and they told him it was the front main seal. So he comes over and he tells me it's a front main seal. I ordered the front main seal like probably, I don't know, 3 days ago. We had agreed about a week ago he was gonna bring it by. Ordered the front main seal. I was gonna charge him $450 to do the front main seal, but it turns out it's not the front main seal. When I washed the engine, I washed all this, it turns out that it's this right here. You guys can catch it right there. You guys can see it's ripped. So this thing was pouring, and yeah, it's pouring, and it falls right here. It leaks right there, and it makes it look, because the engine is turning, so it's smearing it or squirting it that way. So they thought it was a front main seal, but it's not. It's, you guys can catch it right here. Yeah, right there. It's, so they sell the kit with the three seals for the VTEC solenoid and that bracket or attachment, oil filter attachment or bracket or whatever they call it. But I'm gonna go to the auto parts. It's only $16, $15.99. I'm gonna go to the parts store, bring that back, put it back on, and yeah, I'm probably gonna charge him $150 instead of the $450, just because it's a lot easier. It's the only downfall is that I had to remove. Good thing I saw it, I catched it after I washed it all. I was gonna make sure, and yeah, it turns out it's that. But otherwise, I would have done the whole front main seal, removed timing belt, tensioner, and all that, and it would have been back to square one. So I always check them, even though they come and say they diagnosed them somewhere else or they checked them out somewhere else. That's how I am, and that's why I do this. I'm gonna save this guy $300, and yeah. So that's that. You guys have a Honda or V6. It could be anything. Honda Odyssey. There's a lot of other cars that have the same feature on the bottom. That's what it is. It's, don't go just by the, oh, I think it's the front main seal. I'm gonna do that really quick and then send this guy home, or send this van to its owner.